Oh, hey there. I was just looking up information on how to fix a faucet. I turned off the kitchen faucet after washing my hands and noticed that there was still some water dripping out of it. And I don't want to waste water. Oh, don't worry, Squeaks. Squeaks is worried that if we waste too much water, the world could completely run out. And I can see why you would think that. Sometimes when we waste something or use more than we need, we run out of it. Like if you use way too much toilet paper in the bathroom soon, you won't have any left. But I'm happy to say that the Earth isn't going to completely run out of water. Our planet has a lot of water. Look, Squeaks, this is what the Earth looks like from outer space. All of that blue we see is ocean. You can see that most of the Earth is covered with ocean, and oceans are full of water. In fact, they contain almost all of the water on Earth. We can show that on this chart. If this circle showed all of Earth's water, this much of it would be in the oceans. Oh. I see what you mean, Squeaks. Squeaks mentioned that even though there's lots of water in the oceans, it isn't water we can drink. And he's right. That's because ocean water is salt water. That means, well, it's got a lot of salt in it. And that's just fine for the animals and plants that live in the ocean. Those animals can drink salt water, and the plants can use it to grow. But many of the plants and animals that live on land can't use salt water. Like, if people drink ocean water, it'll make them sick. Our pets and farm animals can't drink it either. And ocean water isn't good to use on the plants in our gardens. So we need to use what's called fresh water. Fresh water doesn't have a lot of salt in it. But here's the thing. If we look at our chart again, we can see that only about this much of Earth's water is fresh, which isn't a lot. And we can't use a lot of Earth's fresh water either. Good question, Squeaks. To see why, let's look at the Earth from space again. Most of our planet's fresh water is frozen into ice. A lot of it is at Earth's north and south poles. To use this frozen water, we'd have to get to it, let it melt, and take it to where we need to use it. That's a lot of work. So this water is really hard to use. Other fresh water is under the ground. We can get to a little of it, but most of it is so deep that we can't access it. So, if we take away the fresh water that's frozen or is in a place where we can't use it, that leaves us with only this much for all the people on Earth to use. And that's where not wasting water comes in. The Earth isn't going to run out of fresh water. Even once you use fresh water to brush your teeth or wash your hands, it eventually gets cleaned up at special buildings and put back into the water supply for other people to use. But that process still takes some time. So we need to do our part to make sure there's always enough clean, fresh water for everyone to use every day. That's a great question. I'll work on fixing the faucet, but there are also some easy things you can do to help. Probably the easiest thing to do is to make sure that you turn off the faucet all the way when you're done using it. Even a little bit of dripping can add up to a lot of wasted water. Another easy thing, you can turn off the tap while you brush your teeth. Just by doing this, you can save about 30 liters of water a day. That's almost 8 big jugs of milk. There are also things you can do to save water when it's time to get clean too. Like taking a shorter shower can help. See if you can take one in less than 5 minutes, as long as you're still washing up. Or if you'd like baths instead, you can use the bathtub stopper right when you turn on the faucet, instead of letting the water run down the drain until it gets hot. You can also help keep Earth's water clean by making sure you throw trash away in garbage cans when you're outside. And of course, you can also help by learning more about Earth's water. The more we all know, the better we can take steps to make sure that everyone has the clean, fresh water they need. And on that note, I think I'm ready to try fixing the kitchen faucet. Come on, Squeaks. Let's go save some water. Thanks for joining me here at the fort. If you want to keep learning and having fun with Squeaks, me, Jesse, and all our other friends, be sure to hit the subscribe button. And we'll see you next time on SciShow Kids.